Hello again. This is a tutorial about Wade's event system. I'll just carry on from where I left with my previous tutorial. That was about animation. So I've got a character on the screen. It's a sprite with an animation that's called clap. And in fact, I'm going to make this animation inactive for the time being, so the character is not clapping all the time. So now I'm going to make it a bit interactive by making it clap when the user clicks on the character. So, how do we do that? It's actually pretty simple. Let's go to functions, and here's a big list of predefined events, and there are things that can happen to your selected object. In particular, we are interested in on mouse down or on click, whichever you prefer. Now, the name may be confusing because it's called on mouse down, but what happens in reality is if you are on a touchscreen device, you touch the character and its on mouse down function is called. So, you know, you don't need to worry about whether the user has a mouse or not, it just works. So, let's make the character clap when it's clicked. Since we are going to write a function that's a member function of this object, we refer to this object as this. So we'll just do this.playAnimation and we type the animation name clap. So as you can see, as I type it comes up with a list of suggestions for autocomplete. And if I move my mouse over an identifier, it will say what I'm actually doing. So, in this case, it's saying this function is used to play an animation. And it gives you all the details about the parameters that you can pass to it. So that's it, I'm just writing this short line of code and then I just press play. Here's the idle character. I click it and it starts clapping. So that's how easy it is to make things happen in response to events. Now, obviously it gets a little bit more interesting with all the things you can do. So let's make another example. Actually, let's go back to the shop. We will go into the art category. And we're going to get another free product. It's called, it's in the backgrounds category on the second page. It's called free landscapes. And I'll just download this again and extract it anywhere. It doesn't matter because we're going to import it into our project. So it doesn't really matter where it is on my hard drive. The important thing is I pick one of these landscapes and I drag it here, so it's now part of the project, and I can drag it here, so it's in the scene. However, it's appeared in front of my character, so I'll just have to move to the back. And what I want to do now is... wait... This character looks way too big, so I'll make her a little bit smaller. Go back to all the animations that we have downloaded for Gaia and look for walk underscore left. Actually, a walk right. It's just an example, really. So we import this animation, Gaia walk side right, select Gaia's sprite, and add an animation called walk right. I'll call it walk right with a capital W, just to be consistent with whatever I've done before, but it doesn't really matter. And as an image, we're going to use our walk animation, which is actually 4x4. So, the next thing we're going to do is make her walk when the user clicks on the background. It's actually quite easy. Let's select the background, go to its functions, and on mouse down, we want the character to go where we clicked. So, first of all, actually, we want to get the character object. And to do this, we'll just use the character's name, Gaia. So, var Gaia equals wade.getSceneObject Gaia. So, this gives us the object that's named Gaia. Then, we play the walk right animation for Gaia. And then we make her go to the position that's been clicked. So you see, when these events fire, these functions are all passed a parameter that's called data. And this data parameter contains all the information about the event. So in this case, we are interested in data.screenPosition.x. So the x coordinate of where we've clicked on the screen. So remember, this function is only executed when you click on the background object, because now we are in the functions for the background object. So we want the character to go there on x. So what about the y coordinate? We want the character to go to wherever she is at the moment. So we need to do Gaia.getPosition.y. Finally, Gaia.moveToXy with a speed of 100 pixels per second. Again, if you put the mouse over the function name, it tells you everything about all the parameters, and as you can see, speed is in world units per second. In our case, this means pixels per second. So now let's press play. And we click here, and Gaia just walks there. As you can see, we've made a mistake because the animation is not looping, but it's easy to fix. Let's just select Gaia again, go to the sprites, go to the walk animation, and make it loop. Then I click, and there she goes. Obviously, she doesn't stop because we haven't told her to stop. In fact, actually, we could do that now. Let's add yet one more animation to Gaia. This is going to be an idle animation. I'm just going to call it idle. And I'm just going to make it use the idle image that we have. So, go back to the background object and its on mouse down function. Go back to Gaia and let's select her on move complete function. So this event is fired when the character reaches her destination. So when she stops moving. When she stops moving, we can do this because we are referring to this object or the owner of this function, so to speak. So this.playAnimationIdle. So now I click somewhere, she walks there, and then goes back to the idle animation. So that's the idea. There is a list of predefined events, and you can also add custom functions to your objects. So you can make up whatever name you want, and you can edit them all in here.